Have you ever wanted to sound like you know about tanks, but don't want to put in the effort of actually researching them? Well, fortunately enough for you, that's what I'm here for. I'll be giving you a surface-level knowledge on tanks, starting with the most common known tanks, like the Panzerkampfwagen and the Tiger, and then going to tanks not as popular, but probably cooler, like the M67 Zippo and the T-14 Armada. So with that out of the way, let's start with the Panzerkampfwagen V Panther, or just the Panther for short. There's five versions of this tank, 1 through 4 just being called Panzers, with the fifth being a Panther. The Panther was designed during late World War II to combat Soviet tanks. A Panther typically had a crew of up to 5, and had a turret that could swivel a full 360 degrees, and if run correctly, could fire up to 6 rounds per minute. The Panther was usually assumed to be one of the best, if not the best, tanks used in World War II. Keeping the theme of German tanks, we have the Tiger II, or it's nicknamed the Tiger B. The Tiger B was developed to combat the oncoming forces of the Allies during World War II. 1,500 of them were ordered, however only 1,347 were ever made. The Tiger II had heavy front armor, which gave it an advantage over any tank that tried to face it head-on. The Tiger B was also able to hit tanks at over 2.5 kilometers away. Next up, we have the Soviet T-34. No, not that. This. Anyways, this T-34 was the Soviet's main tank, with over 80,000 of them being produced. However, they also lost a little over 44,000 of the tanks throughout the war. The T-34 had heavily sloped armor, which made up for the lower thickness of the armor. While the T-34 first had a large advantage, it eventually started to fall behind because the focus of the Soviets became quantity, not quality, allowing the better trained and better built German tanks to take out several of the Soviet tanks before they themselves were taken out. The M4 Sherman was the tank mainly used by the Americans and Western Allies during World War II. The Sherman had effective armor during the beginning of the war, however towards the end of the war it needed a compound angle to withstand rounds from the German tanks. The tank had a 75mm turret and a one-axis gyroscope to attempt to keep the turret steady. Fast forward a couple years and we have the Vietnam War, meaning new, innovative tanks. For the example, the M48 Patton. The Patton was the tank mainly used by the Americans during Vietnam. With new weapon technology, normal steel armor could no longer cut it, so instead the Patton was outfitted with fused silica glass, allowing extra defense against HEAT, HEP, and HE rounds. On the much more extreme side of tanks, we had the flamethrower tank M67, or as it was nicknamed, the M67 Zippo, and as you probably guessed from the name, it was a flamethrower tank. The Zippo used a modified M48 Patton as the hull and changed the turret to be a flamethrower. The M67 to date was the last flamethrower tank ever made by the US. Probably because burning people alive is a moral gray area when it comes to war crimes. Now, fast forward a couple decades and we have the M1 Abrams. The M1 Abrams was a new generation of tanks, with concealment methods prepared such as smoke screens, and things like night vision. The tank also had a new type of armor that used depleted uranium, however, the uranium also came at a cost due to the weight of it. It could reach a speed of up to 45 miles per hour on roads and 30 miles per hour cross country. This tank has been the most recent American tank, and so far, other than upgrading the M1 Abrams, no new tanks have been designed or made by the US. The Russians, however, are still on top of things, with their most recent tank being made and announced in 2015, the T-14 Armada. This absolute unit of a tank is an unmanned turret, guided missiles, controlled detonation shells, 12.7mm machine gun, the ability to go 56 miles per hour, tandem charges, internal armor capsules, anti-aircraft missile suspension, dual explosive reactive armor, kinetic energy penetrators, night vision, and most importantly, it has a toilet in it.